Welcome, Cancerians, and thank you for being here today. This is your weekly love message for week commencing Monday the 29th of March through to Sunday the 4th of March 2021. I've already pulled your crowning message card and your crowning wisdom message card. Let's have a look and see what they're telling us, Cancer. Okay, so for your first crowning message, we have mysticism. Now, this is surrounded by that purple, which is connected to that third eye chakra. It's as though, Cancerians, something is being revealed to you, but you may not be able to see it, if that makes sense. It almost feels as though it's a bit mysterious. It's like your intuition is showing you something. The story behind this particular card is that this woman is called Aubergine, okay? And basically, Aubergine has, how can I put it? There's a party that's going on, and Aubergine is going along to the party. But the people hosting the party haven't invited her, okay? But she turns up anyway. Now, the moral of the story is there is something that you know intuitively is coming towards you, but you just don't quite know what it is. And I feel as though you're being guided to follow your intuition, okay? There is an element of mysticism around you, almost as though prayers have been answered. But you may not be seeing it. You may be kind of still kind of wondering, when are your prayers going to be answered? But actually, it's arriving, or it's arrived in the form of the woman Aubergine. It's as though it's there. It's like, but you may not be able to see it. And I feel with this third eye chakra, you're being guided to allow divine spirit to unveil your eyes so that you can see the woman Aubergine coming towards you, because I feel as if it's there. What you are seeking is there. Then we have insecurity. We have insecurity, and this is surrounded by red, which is around the root chakra, okay, your foundation. Now, the story behind this card is we've got Bob here, and Bob is, he is somebody that starts projects but never quite finishes them, because he doesn't believe that they're going to mount to anything, so he kind of stops-starts things. But one day he actually starts something and he finishes it and he's absolutely elated, okay? And then guess what happens? You've got Demon Red Rainbow popping in. And what Demon Rainbow is doing is almost popping holes at Bob, almost probing them, probing Bob and reminding him of his fears. Okay, and as he's popping Bob, it's like Bob then all of a sudden gets that insecure feeling again that the project that he's now completed isn't going to be fruitful. It isn't going to yield what it's supposed to yield. And I feel as though Cancerians, there is something that I feel as if you're insecure about, and you're being guided to face your fears and don't let your fears, because that's what the Demon Red Rainbow represents, fears. And I feel as though that the fears that you have within you is affecting your heart. And I feel as if you're being guided to focus on that, ground yourself so that you can build that solid foundation, almost have the confidence to go forward. So in a nutshell, Cancerians, it's as though there's something that you have been praying for, asking spirit, divine, universe, but at the same time, I feel as if you've already received it, but you're not seeing that you've received it. And I feel as though it's because you are operating from a place of fear or insecurity. It's like, you know, when they say it's like you see something, but you're not really seeing it. That's what I feel with these cards that have been pulled for you. For your third crowning message, we have self-worth. And the orange is around the sacral. You feel this person that's coming towards you. You feel, but you're not seeing. And I feel as if you're scared. You're scared that actually you may not be worthy enough. It's as though, oh, how can I put it? It's like you see, but you're not seeing. And there may be people around you that, if you're talking about this person, it's as if they're saying to you, nah, they're not somebody special, you know, nah, they're not attracted to you. And I feel as though you're being guided to almost ignore what people are telling you that you're seeing, if that makes sense, because there's something deep within you that knows that this person that's coming towards you is somebody really special. And I feel as though it's somebody that Divine Spirit Universe has answered your prayers about. Your intuition is telling you they've arrived. But because you're kind of fearful that, oh my gosh, this person has proper come into my life, you're operating from a place of insecurity. So then what you do is you may be talking to people that are saying, you know what, I've met somebody and do you know what, I think they're the one. And I feel as though people are saying to you, no, there's no way that that person fancies you, or there's no way that this person is going to have a long-term commitment with you. And I feel as though you're being guided to kind of ignore that, because what you see, not everybody sees, and that's your intuition coming in. Now, the story with this self-worth card, you've got the salmon chair, okay? And look at that light shining down. And that light is the great servant, Divine Spirit Universe, okay? That is almost protecting this salmon chair. Also around the salmon chair, you see the valley and you see the river. Again, it's as though they are the earth angels protecting that chair, okay? Then you've got this young child that comes towards this chair. And I feel as though it's kind of like asking the chair, you know, why are you here? You know, why are you sort of sat there just sort of like doing nothing really? And they're kind of like, because I'm here to shine love. I'm here to give love, be love. I am love. And so what the child does, the child goes home and tells its parents that, you know, they saw this salmon chair. You know, and the child relayed the conversation that he or she can't really see there about what the salmon chair had basically said, that it's there to give love, to be love. It is love, and it's protected. And not only is it protected from Divine Spirit Universe, but it's also protected on the earth plane. Okay. And because the child's parents doesn't believe them, you know, he or she goes back to their room, closes their eyes, almost kind of like, I know what I saw. I know what I saw. I know what I felt with that sacral. Okay. And lo and behold, as the child opens their eyes, salmon chair is right at the bottom of their bed. And it's saying, come and sit in me. Let me love you. Let me protect you. I am love. You are love. And what you see and what you heard me telling you is the truth. Just because your parents didn't see me doesn't mean I'm not real. And so Cancerians, in a nutshell, in a really peculiar way, it's as though somebody, I feel, is entering your life, somebody that you've prayed about, wished about, and there's a certain mysticism about them, but you feel them. It's as though you feel as if you know this person, all right? And I feel as if you do. It's as if Divine Spirit Universe has gifted this person, has answered your prayers. But whoever you're talking to, they are almost saying to you, no, 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 you know, that person isn't going to, you know, you're not going to have a relationship with that person, or no, they're not attracted to you. But guess what? I feel as though what it's done is triggered fear within you and made you quite insecure. And I feel as if you're being guided to remember the feeling of self-love, the feeling of self-worth, knowing that, you know what, whatever people are telling you, whatever you're seeing and you're believing and you're feeling, other people can't see it. Other people can't feel it. And therefore, I feel as if you're being guided to believe, have faith. Have faith in yourself. Have faith in what your intuition is telling you about this person, I feel, that is around you, coming into your life, somebody that you, I feel that someone that's quite new, okay? And look at that, interesting. For your card, we've got a personal issue reaches resolution. So I feel as though, and the blue here representing the throat chakra, I feel as though you're going to talk to this person, all right? And I feel as though the personal issue is that you don't believe that this person is really significant, or that you like that, like it's like everyone telling you like, no, 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 this person isn't going to be attracted to you. It's almost as if you feel as if you're not worthy to be with this person. And I feel as though this week that's going to resolve itself. And that may be something, Cancerians, that you have, that's plagued you for a while. It's like you meet people that you have that connection with, but for whatever reason, it's as though you don't believe in yourself. You don't. So then, because you are operating from that place of fear or insecurity, you then pull back your energy. This person that's coming in, I almost feel as if it's Divine Spirit Universe bringing in somebody that is extremely special, and there is this mysticism around them. You can't put your finger on it. You're just drawn to them, but your insecurity, your self-worth, I feel as if that's what you're questioning. And I feel that your crowning message is saying, don't do that. Don't allow fear to help you move forward, because what you're feeling around this person, you're seeing them, you know them, but you're not seeing them, if that makes sense, because you're listening to a lot of tete-a-tete behind, you know, with friends or work colleagues or family. Trust your intuition, okay? Your crowning wisdom message is whale song resonating, and this is really beautiful because this is transformation. Personal issue. This is something that you've had to deal with for a long time. Okay, it's almost as if you just don't trust your own gut, your own intuition, and I feel as though it is now time to sing the song with the whales. Okay, and the whales is about that emotion, that feeling. Look at all of the water around here. You resonate with this person, and I feel as if you're being guided to open yourself to that emotional floodgate of what you're feeling, that intuition, and allow transformation of fear, of self-doubt, and walk into the emotion of feeling secure, feeling confident, knowing that you are loved by divine spirit universe. And why the heck not? Why would, you know, somebody, whoever you are connecting with you, why would they not want to be with you? You're wonderful. And I feel as though that's what divine spirit universe is trying to say to you. And then we've got Horseman, Herald of Change. This is such a beautiful card because it's representing Cancerians, that you are on a verge of change, right? It's literally right in front of you. You can almost touch it, see it, smell it. And I feel as though the Horseman is coming in to say change is coming. It's as though divine spirit is pouring out all of those blessings, all of that love, encouraging you to sing your own song, to trust your intuition and be open to the blessings of change. And look at this. Then we've got Netcaster, preparations come to fruition. And do you remember what we were saying about prayers or manifestations, intentions that you may have set or been asking the universe, your higher self, whatever your beliefs are? It's as though, you know, for a long time, I feel, Cancerians, you've been asking for, all I want is just somebody that's genuine, somebody that I can love, somebody that will love me. And guess what? You've got it. And I feel as though divine is saying is that the net has been cast. OK, and all of your prayers, all of your manifestations, your intention setting, you've already got it. You've already got it. But for some reason, I feel as though, you know, they're trying to say to you, they're trying to open up your third eye chakra and say they're here. What you have been praying for, wishing for, manifesting, it's here. So trust your intuition. It feels as though you're being guided to prepare for all the blessings that are coming with this person. It's time to put the cast, put the net down. You've caught what you needed to catch. Yeah. And I feel as though the feelings is, I feel as though you're just being guided to allow divine spirit to bask, to shine that light and just sit in that salmon chair and just feel the comfort of that love and knowing that this person has come into your life for a reason. So it's like, don't listen to other people, sing your song, know the blessings are coming towards you, and everything that's going on right now, I feel as though this week is just, it's just preparing you. It's preparing you basically to resolve a personal issue of feeling as if you're not good enough or feeling as if your person is never going to enter your life. That I feel you're on the verge of real, real big change. That's for the Cancerians that I'm reading for this week. Cancerians, I'm doing obviously the chakra reads this week. So they are very long-winded because there's so much in them. So you know the score. Click the thumbs up button if it resonates. Subscribe if you would like to know when I'm uploading new messages. Let's get straight into your love message. My angels and spirit guides of the divine, please can you tell me, how does the soulmate of Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus feel towards them in love? Week commencing Monday the 29th of March through to Sunday the 4th of April 2021. What is their current energy spiritually, emotionally, mentally and physically towards Cancer that I'm allowed to see for their highest good and for the greater good of all? As above, so below and all around me, thank you. Very profound. I do love doing the chakra reads. They're very deep, very deep. My angels and spirit guides of the divine, please, can you tell me, how does, thank you. We have the Queen of Cups. We have Temperance. Yes, absolutely. Whoever they're in, they have a, whoever's coming in, they have a lot of love for you. And look at that. You've got The third eye chakra opening up around the Queen of Cups. You've got the third eye chakra opening around with the mysticism. And look, you've got this female energy. So somebody, whether they are male or female, I feel as if their feminine energy is quite heightened this week. And I feel as if you're insecure about them, all right? They're being quite patient with you with that Temperance card, because I feel as if they know that you feel as though you're not worthy to be with them, all right? You could be dealing with Sagittarius, or you may have Sagittarius in your chart. Again, notice the red of the root chakra. I feel as though this person has been brought into your life to help you feel secure within this relationship. Feel secure that they have come into your life with a heck of a lot of love, unconditional love, and they're just waiting for you to see it. And then look at that. We've got the Queen of Swords. We have got the King of Coins, beautiful, and the Princess of Cups, awesome. Okay, so Cancerians, I feel right at the heart of your reading with that Queen of Swords here. I feel as though your third eye chakra is opening up. And I feel as though this is your energy, whether you are male or female. I feel as though you're being guided to see the truth, okay? It's a personal issue that I feel that it's been a challenge for you for a long, long time. And it's like all you want is truth. I feel as though you're quite decisive. It's kind of like, you know, you may have this feeling that you know somebody, or you feel that deep connection. But then if it's not reciprocated in any shape, form or another, you just kind of cut it out. You're quite blunt like that. I feel it's almost as if, you know what, I'm not even wasting my time. I feel that you're being guided to speak the truth to yourself. And the truth is, you feel this connection, okay? And even though you may be going to other people to help you decipher it, they cannot see what you can see. They cannot feel what you feel. And therefore, you're being guided to almost speak truth to yourself. And as you do, I feel as though you're being guided with that King of Coins energy. And this is the crown chakra opening up to allow divine spirit universe to help you sing that song, your song, okay, of emotion, allow transformation. And I feel as though, Cancerians, whether you are male or female, I feel as though you're solid, you're grounded, you're nurturing. And I feel as though it's going to take some time for you to almost accept these blessings, okay? But once you do, it's going to be really, really solid. With the Princess of Cups, I feel as though, this may actually be your energy. Your energy. And I feel as though you have a lot of love for this person who is the Queen of Cups. And I feel as though male or female, it doesn't matter. But I feel the King of Coins and this Princess of Cups is your energy. I feel as though in your heart space, the green is the heart chakra. I feel as though all you want to do is give this love. It's like it's time. And I feel as though the Cancerians that I'm reading for, I feel as if you have a lot of love within you that you want to give, but you're not confident, because when you feel that connection with somebody, it's almost as if you don't trust it. And I feel as though divine spirit, with that crown chakra coming in, knows that you are solid, knows that you are grounded, and knows that you have a lot of love in your heart to give. And I feel as though your prayers, your affirmations, your manifestations, your intention setting I feel as though it's been heard, okay? And this person is being brought into your life to fulfill that yearning, that need to share this love that's in your heart to give, because I feel as though you have a lot of love in your heart to give. And I feel as though with that Queen of Swords, you need to almost speak that truth to yourself. This person also may see you as somebody that they do hold in high regard, but I feel as if their third eye chakra is opening to see that you are protecting your heart, okay? And I feel as though they know that they have been brought into your life to help you almost build that foundation, that root chakra, and come in with this love. And they're being patient because they know that part of their job or their role in your life is to come to you solid, yeah, to strengthen that root chakra. Let's have a look at your clarifications. My angels, thank you. Look at that, the Eight of Swords. And I feel as though the person that you are connecting with, I feel as though they are... they're caught up in their head, they're analysing, and I feel as though what they're being revealed in their third eye chakra, blending into that sort of pinky ready, which is just exactly the cards, the colours of the cards that are coming out here. It's as though they see that they're in your life to help to build a solid foundation, but they are analysing it because, do you know what, they see that you're insecure. All right. So they are really analyzing it, being patient. They know that their purpose is to help you along this journey of resolving this personal issue. I feel that has plagued you for a hot minute when it comes to relationships. Let's continue. Thank you. Look at that, Ten of Pentacles. This person wants to build a future with you, and it's coming from their heart space. So I feel as if they're genuine and they're speaking it to you with that blue. So I feel as though they may even have a conversation as they analyze. I feel what they're analyzing is to be, it's like they're being guided with their third eye chakra. To come in, speak truth from their heart that you what they want to build a future with you, to build this solid foundation, build that root chakra. But what they're analyzing is that, like, they need to choose their words carefully. That's why they're being patient, all right? It's like they have to tread carefully with you, because guess what? If they say the wrong thing, you're going to cut them out. Look at that, the Nine of Cups. This person sees you, you are their happiness. They feel as if they've met somebody that is their wish fulfillment. You make them happy. And again, look at the purple coming in, their third eye chakra fully open to see that you are their wish fulfillment, and they need to speak it in some shape, form or another. But again, they're being patient. They don't want to get cut by you. They don't, you know, it's like they're analysing with that Eight of Swords. Look at that. Oh my gosh. This one came out first. Hold on a minute, Cancerians. Six of Swords. So look at that. They see, okay. Oh, all right, Cancerians, with the Six of Swords, this is all about moving out of choppy waters into calm waters. They know that their purpose is to help you out of this personal issue that you need to resolve, okay? With the orange blending into the yellow, it's as if they feel they need to take the action to help you move forward, okay? But they know they need to have a conversation. They know that they need to be mindful of that conversation, because you might lash out, okay, in some shape, form or another. And look at that, we've got the Ten of Cups. Again, in their heart, they're speaking truth. With that Ten of Cups, you are their happiness. This is your energy. They see you as their Ten of Cups. So I feel as though for a long time, this person may have been operating on a Nine of Cups. So I would say that this person might be a little bit well-to-do. That might be why you're feeling really insecure. You may feel as though they are out of your league. Okay, but guess what? They see you as their 10th card. And judge, look at that, judgment. And I straight away, I was drawn to the self-worth. You've got the sacral, okay, blending in with that solar plexus slightly. I feel as if call to action on your feelings of what you feel for this person. You feel this person on a deep, deep soul level and you want reconciliation. And I feel as if your call to action basically is to sit in the salmon chair and let divine spirit universe embrace you with that great servant of love and protection, okay? As you move forward to your call of action to move forward with this person, all right? My angels and spirit guides, thank you. Oh, look at that. Yeah, you've had your heart broken. That's why you're so cautious. That's why you're so insecure. And it cut you right in your heart. And I feel as though you're being guided to, you probably need to speak about it with the blue coming there around the throat chakra. Isn't that interesting? Because look at the blue here and the blue here. Transformation, you need to talk about it. And with that King of Swords coming in, I feel as though this is their energy. And you know what's really interesting? You've got the King of Swords and the Queen of Swords. I feel in a very peculiar way, Cancerian, your intuition is telling you the mysticism of this person, your third eye chakra is opening up. You feel this person, that they are your divine counterpart. And I feel as if you already know intuitively that they're here to help build a solid foundation, which we can see here and we can see here on their side. And it's all centered around truth. It's all centered around truth. And I feel as though you're being guided that it's safe to talk to this person about a broken heart, bereavement, loss, because that's why you're slow to come forward with a solid offer. Because you don't want to get your heart broken. Thank you. Cancerians and the sun, I just got a chill right down me. So look at that solar plexus. The actions that you take with this person is going to be abundant, fruitful, prosperous. It's the best card in the whole of the deck. So do you remember we were saying, Cancerians, that you have all of this love in your heart and that cup is going towards this person? You just want to give that love. Look at the blessings. You're on the verge of change. You've got what you want. And the sun is just coming in to say, this is it. This is the person. Abundance, prosperity. Giving your love to this person is going to be victorious for you. Oh, and what? Thank you. Oh, two. Oh, look at that. Oh, my God. Well, that card came out first. So you've got the Seven of Wands. It's as though you know intuitively, Cancerians, you know you've met the person that you're supposed to be with. And I feel with that Seven of Wands, it's victory. It's victory, fighting for what you want, fighting for your person to build that solid foundation. Look at that red chakra coming in here and here, which we can see that this person has been brought into your life to build a solid foundation. And look with the Lover's card, twin flame. Okay, your ultimate soul connection. And you know what? You feel it. Look at that sacral and the solar plexus. You feel this person and you know that you need to take action towards them, because guess what? They are your person. Oh, that is so beautiful. Couldn't even make it up, even if I tried. That's so lovely. All right, Cancerians, let me have a look at your advice cards. Okay, all right, my angel. Ooh, okay. Look at that. I straight away, as soon as that came out, my eyes moved to the sun, abundance, The world is abundant when you choose to see it that way. Solar plexus. Take the action. Take the action, Cancerians, towards this person, because there's great abundance with them. Yeah, there's no need to feel insecure. Push down the red demon rainbow that is mucking around with you. All right, there's nothing to fear. You have met somebody extremely important. And look, as you do so, as you take that action, harmony makes the song of life sweeter. Look at that, the whale song. This person, we kept talking about this foundation, building this foundation. As you both come into union, guess what? Your chakra balances out. Perfect alignment, perfect foundation, everything as it should be. Singing that song. Yeah, singing that song. Dreams, throat chakra. So we were picking up, there needs to be a conversation. It's safe to speak to this person. They need to speak to you to let you know they want to talk to you, but they are being very careful about what they say because they don't want to be cut out. Look at your final card. Third eye chakra is coming in. Yes, speaking truth. Dreams are where your mind translates the divine, but also with that third eye chakra as well, it's opening up. I saw the blue here, okay? So I just feel as if it's a double whammy message in the one card. Your third eye chakra is open. This person's third eye chakra is open. And I feel there's a lot of truth that needs to be spoken. This person, I feel, is somebody that you've been dreaming about, wishing for, hoping for, praying. And I feel as though the world is abundant if you see it that way. And I feel as though as you sit in that salmon chair, because people haven't seen the love, the feeling, the intuition that you feel for this person, does not mean that your dreams haven't been answered. They have with the netcaster. You're being prepared to receive these blessings. You are on the verge of massive change, okay, with the horseman coming in there. Your dreams are answered. Dreams are where your mind translates the divine. I feel as though Cancerians, whoever you're connecting with, they have divinely been guided to be in your life. It feels as though divine is saying, do you know what? We see that you're solid. We see that you have all of this love in your heart to give. We see that you have been wishing, praying, hoping for the love of your life to come in. And I guess what? I feel as though this week you're on that journey. You've received it. You may not be seeing it, but you are seeing it, if that makes sense. Trust your intuition. It's not gonna lead you astray. Forget what other people say. Just listen to what your heart is saying and sing your song. Beautiful. Cancerians, I'm going to leave that there for you. If it resonates, you know the situation, click that thumbs up on the video. If you haven't subscribed and you'd like to know when I'm uploading new messages, please click that subscription button. All information is down below in the description box if you would like to find out more information. Until next time, Cancerians, sending you loads and loads of love, peace and light. Take care. Bye-bye.